have the, use the take advantage of the full, four, you know, 4:3 anamorphic. Previously, I could only use spherical, you know, and now I feel like the whole lens gamut is opened. I love the skin tone on this camera. So kind of the smooth kind of latitude that it has right now. Not as electronic, a little bit more kind of a little bit more homey. Tremendous range in the highlights. You know, finding that I could push it further than I've ever had before.
Very similar to that of film because you have so many types of colors. So you may have thousands of shades of green, red, or blue. An extremely wide amount of colors.
Or all the NDs that are in the camera. 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, 18, 21, and 2.4. So I always figure it's really nice just to kind of craft the depth of field.
The workflow is almost identical. It uses the same media, the same R7 recorder as the previous Sony camera generation. So it's a very simple format to work with.
And we just threw them in the heat and the dust and the dirt and to kind of just see how hot it could run. And it didn't overheat at all. It just did what we would normally do. When you turn it on, 5 seconds later, you have a picture. Sometimes when you have to swap a battery, you have to turn the camera off. Everyone's like, no, don't turn the camera off. We can't afford the time. But with this camera, you're like, no, it'll just be back on in a few seconds.
And not waiting on the camera. You're waiting on your creativity.
Nice, the new body is slimmed up to somewhere around like this, which makes my lenses choices on the other end much more, which is super important to me to have that available to me. There's two menu panels on the camera. There's one for the camera side, which has the full set of menu data, and there's also one for the DP operator, which is a little smaller menu that's on his side.
We've had very little limitations and fully creative freedom.